He's hit good. He just went down. Good hit, B. Good hit. Oh my good gracious. Oh, this buck, I'll tell you what. Steve's been watching this buck. Thank you, Steve. This is his place. He got permission on this place. And I'll tell you what, man, it was last year he chased a big buck in here with the muzzleloader. Came close a few times, just couldn't close the deal. Especially when you got a camera with you. It's really difficult because you got two, three guys. You know, you're trying to get set up. Came in bow hunting. He came really close this year. He got a couple good full draws on this buck, but unfortunately for him, I have a rifle tag. And 300, what was he, Steve? 348?
348.
348 yards in the 270 with the Barnes XXX just put a smack on him. Oh, I'm fired up. Yep, he's down there dead. He's a long ways away. We're going to definitely have to go get the truck to come in on this guy. But, oh, thanks again to Steve. Thanks to Tyler. And that's my first animal on the ground this year. Way to get fired up. And now we got muley tags and driving in today. Steve, Tyler, and I spotted a big, probably pushing 180, big kickers all over. Went to a nice little spot, so we wanted to fill this tag, and now we're going to go back up there and try to get on that muley. Archery season opens today, so thanks, guys. Appreciate it. Let's go get them.
That was exciting.
He's done. So here we go, walking up to that goat I just shot. He's big. He's probably over 15. Heavy, big cutters. He's my best goat by far. This is kind of a bittersweet moment. Steve was wanting to kill this buck with his muzzleloader and his bow this year. Muzzleloader last year. And came close a few times, but thank you for putting the slip on us. He's lived here pretty much his whole life. Steve's seen him in here for like 4 or 5 years. And Steve's neighbor got caught wind of him and had a tag this year, rifle tag, and this buck and his does came off some private ground, and they were working in between Steve's place trying to work into that other property, and those guys were actually sitting up in a truck waiting for him to come up because that's kind of his routine. But we intercepted him, and 340 yard poke later, and he's down. So I cannot wait to put my hands around this beast of an antelope.
I'll tell you the greatest thing about hunting antelope: no track job. It's easy to find them once you knock them down. Gotta love it. A lot different from trailing whitetails in the Milo field. Yeah, he's piled up. He's done. October 1st, 2011 Colorado antelope. And we just got it done. Steve put in a lot of time getting permission out here, got it locked up, been chasing this buck for years and years, finally got on him. Couldn't get it done with the muzzleloader or bow, but we finally got it done with the rifle. It's tough to dodge a 400-yard bullet, so. No guides, no leases, no outfitters, and this is what we're all about. Relentless pursuit, hard work. Came out here, Steve's put in so much time. Thanks, special thanks to Steve for coming out all the time and, you know, trying to kill him. But ultimately, he had a game plan, knew what this buck was gonna do. And sure enough, that's what he did. He came down. He was going to go water in this bottom pond and got it done. 348-yard shot. I'm pretty pleased. I cannot wait to get him on the wall. He's going to make a great trophy, and I am super excited. So the hunting's just begin for me. October 1st, this was my first tag, but now archery muley's opened up. So got a lot of hunting coming up between now and the end of November. Thanks for hanging around. What a great buck.